Would you take $1 million, but you have to slap every baby you see for the rest of your life? Lots of baby slappers in the chat.
What if you go out and there's a field trip and you have to slap the tots around?
Dude, what if you like pass by a daycare and there are like 50 babies out there?
$1 million isn't enough for the legal fees, brah.
Slapping babies is my passion.
And you know what? That is frightening.
How would you safely get food? I saw a baby at the store one time.
DoorDash? But what if there's a baby working at DoorDash? You open the door to get your chalupa, a little 1 foot tall baby sitting there holding the bag. Today we're back in the hypothetical court and the conversations are as stupid as ever. If you didn't see the last video, this is a game made by my friend Wednesday and it lets me discuss some very important topics with my viewers, like should Sasquatches, born in the US, be able to run for president? My viewers all pick a side and then we randomly choose a member of each side to have an intellectual discussion about the topic.
Imagine shaking his hand, it would be so cool.
I know. If they make good points, they can act change everyone's opinion. I can also kill them with this hammer to bring someone else up from their team and give us a fresh perspective. There's also a new feature that lets members of the jury give us talking points on occasion.
How do we know if Sasquatches haven't already been president? Think of like Abe Lincoln? What if he was just a squatch that shaved?
As always, this was live streamed, so if you like the videos, come check out the streams. Would you take $1 million, but you have to slap every baby you see for the rest of your life? Lots of baby slappers in the chat. Whoa, my God, guys, I think you're not fully anticipating, first of all, how frequently you'll see a baby, and second of all, how much jail time you might get for slapping one on the head.
Slap them babies.
Oh my God, we've got a very big split here. Look at the person the slapping cat emote.
$1 million isn't enough for the legal fees, brah.
That's kind of what I'm thinking, dude. I feel like you have, and see, you could go the route of trying to maybe just not ever see a baby again. Jeez Louise, I think that'd be hard. What happens if you're like watching TV and there's like a Pampers commercial? Do you then have to like hunt down?
Enough to get to a nice island. What if I have a kid one day? I would slap my child every day he woke up.
And that's the tragic reality of these type of questions, ladies and gentlemen. I think, a lot of people aren't considering that this would be life ruining for a lot of people.
Also, would I have to slap baby animals too?
Guys, what do you think of the jury? Should they have to slap baby animals? Would that count?
Just slap one kid and run.
Slap one kid and run? That's not the question, my friend. Did you misunderstand? It's every baby you see. Wait, guys, say yes or no, and I'll just look at the thing at the bottom. Should baby animals count?
No.
I can't. Oh, you hush you. I'm gonna say no. I'm gonna say baby animals would not count. All right, guys, I'm gonna bring up a couple new people. Someone just said I would do it for free. You've got.
Hot salad 324 sis. Do you have to keep slapping the same baby?
I would say so. Like, say you walk in the kitchen and your little nephew's sitting there in his high chair, that'd be a slap. And then say you go back to your room, you come back, your little nephew's still sitting there because you forgot your drink. I think that would probably be another slap.
You could just live without somewhere off the grid and don't need the money.
Yeah, but then you're not covered. That's not a very sound plan, because then say someone comes up and says, like, you slapped my baby back in 2023, then you've got no money, and you're also probably gonna be pretty bored up there. I'd like to ask, do either of you see babies frequently? I can't think of the last time I really saw a baby. Nope, I can, guys. I was walking into, I think it was Lowe's or Home Depot or something. Saw a little baby in the carriage, and I'm trying to put myself in those shoes.
No, not really.
But the babies that you did see, what the hell was a baby doing in Lowe's? I don't know, building a crib? I don't know what he was doing. I mean, his parents were probably up to something.
Only at the mall.
Yeah, so guys, I think this brings up an interesting point. I think the amount of times that you could go out and enjoy your life would be significantly cut down, because all of a sudden, you're gonna have to be fearful for every single potential baby.
What about photos?
Yeah, dude, I mean, if you saw a photo of like someone's baby, I think you would probably have to go hunt the thing down. And see, if it's an old photo, maybe they would probably be like 25 or 26 these days, but you'd still, I mean, that would be a slap. I think a lot of your life would be kind of set up to be hunting these babies down and slapping them. That's stupid. I don't make the rules.
Funny baby videos? I was craving. No more of that.
Consider it. All those videos of like the baby, I don't know, like a cat jumps up and like knocks a baby over and they fall down. No more. I will say, I've been
cats
seeing
are better.
I would give you this point. Cause I do agree, cats are better than babies. But overruled because of account of the fact that it has nothing to do with the question. I'm gonna get some more people up here, see what they think. So far the split, it is sort of evening out. No and yes. We're a little bit more even.
Bye.
Any talking points from the jury?
Arctic Stinky Garlic it's says, argument. What if I saw a baby photo of myself?
I mean, that would just be self-inflicted. I feel like you could probably avoid pictures of yourself.
ID argue that maybe an image
so
is
go
an
to
emulation
a
of a baby rather than a baby in and of itself.
An image is an emulation of a baby rather than a baby. See, I think that's a good point.
Shut.
Hey, respect each other in this courtroom. Do not tell people to shut. I agree with that. A picture or a video of a baby is not a baby. That's just a couple pixels on the screen.
What if you go out and there is a field trip and you have to slap the tots around?
Dude, what if you like pass by a daycare and there are like 50 babies out there like walking around and falling and like, I don't know.
Walmart field trip.
I don't know, dude. That would be pretty hard to deal with.
That's what I'm saying.
It is possible to become a hermit worst case scenario.
But that's another interesting point. Would you give up everything?
Then you wouldn't be able to enjoy the million.
Yes, what are you going to do with that millie? What are you going to do with that fat millie? What, are you going to sit there?
Yeah, I'm pretty lazy.
I feel like if you had to go this route, there would most likely be a lot less going out. Because guys, that's seriously life ruining. You go up and slap someone's baby, they're not going to be happy. They're going to be pretty pissed. Guys, thank you for your input. I'm going to bring a couple more people up here. What is your main reasoning for not wanting to take this deal?
I don't like hurting people.
And that's a perfectly fine enough answer. I don't like hurting people either. Must let a baby, a damn innocent little baby, unless I got a million, then maybe, every time I saw
There's a lot of demand for slapped babies. Just look at these votes.
I mean, there are a surprising amount of people who seem to be okay with this and think that you wouldn't...
You can just work and get a million.
Yeah, guys. So true. Guys, all you out there who want a million, just go work. Any good points from the jury? Any counterpoints, arguments?
Jashus the Twitch now says, can I choose to not slap the baby, and what's the penalty? Or am I just physically forced to slap the baby? As in, my body contorts specifically to slap the baby?
I think it would definitely be a forced situation. Does that change any of your guys' minds? Dude, she sounded so, like, panicked. Like, she's, like, got tears coming out of her eyes. She's like...
No. That's a pretty hard debuff.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like you would... I think it would be involuntary. All right. Final yes or no's. You can change your answer. After hearing what you've heard today, what side do you reside on? Still a lot of yeses. It's surprisingly close. I made a typo in the question! All of this has been invalidated! You have to slap every baby you see for the rest of Yoru life!
LOL.
Oh my god. How embarrassing. And you know what? I didn't even word this one as like a yes or no, like, this was like a would you. So this was, I mean, I'm just learning about people in the chat. All right. The consensus is no. That's not a good deal. And I agree with that. Next question. Should Sasquatches, born in the US, be able to run for president? Begin voting. Wow, this might be the biggest yes we've ever seen. We might have a very small group of no's who we're trying to convince here. Wow, that's beautiful. Why would anyone say no? I know. Small Figs, you're a member of no.
Your Highness, if a prisoner can run for president, so can a Sasquatch.
Yeah, I am just kind of a, like, what kind of laws would he pass? There's so much to discuss here. Small Figs, you're a member of Team No. You don't think a Sasquatch should be able to run for president?
My point is that every Sasquatch is being hunted by the IRS for tax evasion.
Hmm. That is true. I don't imagine a Sasquatch pays taxes. And you know what? They might have to answer for some, like, crimes for, like, eating people. Do Sasquatches eat people?
Sasquatches don't have incomes.
That is true.
That's why no one can get a good picture.
You say Sasquatches are hunted for not being paying taxes, but why would they pay taxes? They don't have income. All their possessions is like a stick and berries, dude. Couple leaves in the woods. I mean, they might have like...
Eating people is a myth that was busted in RDR1.
There you have it. Red Dead Redemption 1 proved it long ago. Sasquatches don't eat people. Small Figs, anything else you want to add? Why should a Sasquatch not...
That's a great point, but if they can't get an income, what makes them qualified for president?
What makes them not qualified for president, Small Figs? You're the one who thinks they shouldn't. We would finally get to know...
a U.S. citizen and 35 years of age.
That's all it takes. And I looked this up. You gotta live in the U.S. for 14 years. I say we go out, we find a Sasquatch, we get him a law degree, or what do they need to be president?
I am one.
You're a Sasquatch?
To be honest, I've never met a Sasquatch.
I will run for president thanks to the support.
This is heartwarming. This is very exciting. Small Figs, I'm gonna let somebody from Team
thanks,
No come
guys.
Up and see if they can convince us that we shouldn't have this Sasquatch.
I've been completely defeated. Vote for General.
Bug tries his best. Can you maybe fill us in a little bit? How
Birth
long?
Birth certificate.
Birth certificate. That is very true. Now that you mention it, because a Sasquatch is kind of similar to like a...
Is there proof that they were born in the U.S.?
Like a deer or something. You know? Like, I don't think a deer could run for president.
We have documentation written on leaves.
Sasquatch society has this covered. Bug tries his best.
But will the U.S. government accept such a leave certificate?
If I get voted, I will centralize the documentation for all species in the U.S.
Look at that. And we already have our Sasquatch president. Looking to make plays in the big White House. And then eventually maybe we'll have a porcupine. Maybe we could have like over the hedge. There'd be little animals running around doing stuff. They'd like live with us and like be having jobs and stuff. Or Zootopia. Not over the hedge. No, Zootopia, I think. I haven't seen that movie.
We must come together. We must fight the skinwalkers.
The skinwalkers. The existence of Sasquatch also now makes me wonder about other creatures. And I gotta say, I don't think I would want a skinwalker president.
They exist! They are scary!
Okay.
They ate my brother Unga last month.
Not Unga! That's so sad. A sob story like that will sure to get people to vote for you. All right, guys, I'm gonna get some new people up here. God bless you, you Sasquatch.
My condolences.
Crying Cat, you're one of a very few who don't think that Sasquatch should be able to run for the president. Why?
Do they even speak English?
I don't think that matters. Cause surely there's a guy who knows how
I
to speak both like Sasquatch
Smiley
language
face.
And English. I think he would be very neat. That's what I'm saying. You get a Sasquatch in the room with me and I would just...
Imagine him in his little suit.
Oh my God, and he would be like sitting in his little chair and signing documents. God, what if he like made some cool rules where like, I don't know, like maybe change the United States flag to be like, I don't know, have like a Bigfoot head on it or something cool. Jury, any counterpoints, points?
Footprint.
Fatherless_Ash says, Your Honor, is the Loch Ness Monster allowed to run?
I think I just got out
No.
Last.
So why should this beast?
Why should this beast? This beast? First of all...
Beast?
First of all, watch your disrespectful language in this courtroom.
Objection!
Second of all, I'm on it. Don't you worry.
Mr. Beast.
We're not talking about the Loch Ness Monster. That's a different argument. All right, I'm gonna get some more members of Team No up here.
I believe that their views are just so much different than ours.
Yeah, because then they might start enacting laws about, like, I don't know. What do Bigfoots even do, dude?
Pit bulls eat more babies in a year than Sasquatch has eaten in their entire lifetime.
Not running a country.
Yeah, they are a simple bunch, the Sasquatches. They kind of keep to themselves and just hang out in the woods.
Nene Killa says, like 20% of the chat was ready to eat a baby last question. We can't judge that.
These people don't have sympathy for babies. They would slap one for $1 million.
Jazzbone _ says, how do we know if Sasquatches haven't already been president? Think of, like, Abe Lincoln? He was a tally-hairy dude. What if he was just a squatch that shaved? I think we should welcome them with open arms.
You do bring up a good point. I would argue we probably have had a Sasquatch president or two.
That's probably why they shot Abe.
Oh my god. It's all coming together. It is all making sense in this courtroom today. Guys, I think I'm ready to make my point. Or my decision. Any other good points we need to hear about? Or are we ready to call this thing?
Magneti Teeter says, Sasquatches have created many jobs in the vein of Sasquatch hunters, Sasquatch researchers, Sasquatch artists, and vendors selling Sasquatch merchandise.
That is true. I think Sasquatches have done a lot for the society. And it's about goddamn time. Sorry, Lord. That we let these little guys run for presidency.
Amen.
Should Sasquatch run for president? I think absolutely. The jury has spoken. Look at the numbers. They don't lie. Guys, get to the polls. Vote Sasquatch. Is a werewolf or a vampire more dangerous? Let your voices be heard, Team Werewolf or Team Vampire. Ooh, this is a pretty even split. Man, this one's so evenly split. This is nuts. Vampires can hypnotize people.
Vampires aren't that dangerous at all. We hardly do anything.
Well,
smiley
that might...
face.
We? Guys, I don't know if you can tell, but my hand is shaking like crazy right now. We have to decide if we're thinking of it one of two ways. Are we thinking there's a vampire that lives in my village, and there's also a werewolf that lives in my village? Or are we thinking werewolf, full moon, vampire, and you're in a room with each of them? Which way should we think about it? I think we should go the living in your village. Okay, guys, for this hypothetical, there is a vampire living somewhere in your village, and there is a werewolf living somewhere in your village.
Werewolves are only dangerous on a full moon. Vampires are dangerous all month.
And your response, King of Muffins? Because that is a great point.
What is a vampire going to do? We only take a little bit of blood. Werewolves kill people.
Guys? Well, good point, King of Muffins. There's something I have to do over here.
Guys, I think, I'm not certain, but I think something's fishy about this guy.
Okay, take your time.
Oh shit.
Hey, that pizza doesn't have garlic, does it?
Why, you don't like garlic? Not a big fan?
Nah, not a big fan.
Maybe we hear from the jury a little bit.
Hey, Judge, did the lawyers provide their dental records? You know, like we always ask.
Yeah, that is true. We are a big fan here of finding out if people have like all their teeth, and just because sometimes we don't, like me.
Of course, I provided my dental records.
Yeah, we didn't get anything from Ping of Muffins. Ping, you mind if I come take a look inside your mouth? It's pretty mandatory. That's how we do most things around here. We It's just a formality type thing.
My teeth are totally normal, no need to check.
Okay.
Let's talk about the matter at hand, guys.
You're right. I don't know what... I'm behaving irrationally.
Trindala says, which lore of vampires are we following? Are they able to turn into bats? Or are they like RuneScape and can turn into mist? How strong are they? There are many different lore versions of vampires.
I'm going to say, the vampires in our lore, they can turn into a bat.
Vampires already run the Red Cross.
Now that is another point that I had not thought about, guys. What if vampires are already walking around with everyone? What if vampires are here in our society? I know, I almost slipped up there and said... Alright guys, I'm gonna bring a couple more lawyers up here. Just get some other points.
That's a harmful stereotype. Just because it's blood?
Bye!
Bye! Ping of Muffins, good luck with whatever you get up to.
Ow.
Vampires can have powers. Werewolves only come out at full moons.
Vampire are a lot easier to kill.
And you say this, why? You're Team Werewolf, you think a werewolf is going to be pretty difficult to kill, but what makes you think that you could just easily kill a vampire? Last I checked, most people here are just pretty normal human beings.
They can turn into bats before you stab their heart with a stake.
Exactly. You start stepping too close to this thing, how are you going to sneak up on a vampire?
You only need a crossbow.
They can smell your blood.
This one's tough. Because, like, here's the thing, guys. You put me in a room...
To kill a werewolf, you need a special type of metal bullet.
That is true. Guys, you put me in a room with a vampire and a werewolf, I feel like the werewolf's gonna do so much more damage to me. The werewolf is gonna rip me to shreds. The vampire might be able to be reasoned with, which is, I mean, vampires are sexy, they're kinda hot. They probably, like, wanna play with their food a little bit. And you could probably, I don't know, like, seduce them or something. Werewolf, I don't think is gonna be the case. Oh, don't play dumb with me, you know exactly what I'm talking about.
Vampires can only come at nighttime, which means many people will be asleep, so vampires can kill you without you realizing it before it's too late.
See, this goes back to the village slash room discussion. If we're in a village, if we're in an entire village, I would feel probably safer with a werewolf. But if we're locked in a one-on-one room, a one-on-one confrontation, a battle to the death, then I'm probably gonna say I would be more scared of a werewolf.
Vampires are also a lot easier to recognize. Werewolf in their human form are identical to normal human.
Yeah, that would be just a hairy dude, I think.
What if they have the power to look like a normal
human?
Tomaty
Squirt says vampires are an existential threat to the human species. They need human blood to thrive, so their very existence poses a risk to our existence. If they get organized, they will turn us into livestock.
Oh my god, there's a movie about that. What's that movie? Chat, someone, what's that movie called? There's a movie where they got people hanging up and they're drinking blood out of them. The Matrix? No, that's a... Yeah, Blade, I think that's what I'm thinking of. Vampires only do what they have to do. Werewolves are violent and uncontrollable. Alright, let's hear some more points from the jury.
Gary_Supreme says, you can put up reasonable vampire prevention defenses, but there's not much you can to prevent werewolves from getting to you.
Yeah, that is a point that I'd like to discuss.
Vampires can kill werewolves by draining their blood.
We're not doing a vampire versus werewolf, I don't think. I think it's more like which is more gonna hurt you, which is more dangerous and sucks to be around the most.
We could verify people by using a cross.
We hold up a little cross. In fact, I could probably fashion one out of this right here. I could have a cross within the minute. But we've got a werewolf on the scene. What do you do to prevent him from attacking? I think that's a very good point, because vampires have weaknesses that you could like put a stop to them and be like preventative measures. Werewolf, what do? Like, yeah, they only come out of the full moon, but when they do, they're gonna wreak havoc and they're gonna freaking kill all your damn chickens and livestock. They're gonna freaking eat your little cousin.
Werewolf have ultra strength. They could destroy houses in a matter of minutes.
Oh my god. Look how even this is, 270 to 273. How are we ever gonna get the correct answer here? This is so split. All right, guys, I'm gonna get some more people up here. See if we can get some points that are going to change some minds.
If werewolves are more violent and uncontrollable, then that means vampires have intelligence.
That is another good thing that I think vampires have going for them. They're smart about it. So werewolves, they'll just wander around and just be a whole bastard about it. But you get a vampire with intent, and he knows, like...
What if the answer is a tie?
That is actually a good point, guys. I think, what if it's just the answer is that they're both equal?
The village is screwed because they have a werewolf and vampire. The vampires are more dangerous because if they're hot, I'm going to willingly give my soul.
And guys, that might be just unfortunately the way the cookie crumbles. I think a big part of this is going to be falling into the category of, man, that's such a hot vampire, and maybe it's not so bad if he drinks a little. You know, werewolves are also hot. Guys, I just had a theory. Okay, I'm going to test something really quick. We're gonna end the vote because we're getting nowhere with this, and we're gonna amend this slightly. Who's hotter, a vampire or a werewolf? All right, begin your voting. Okay, this theory's starting to fall apart then. Guys, I was really convinced that a lot of you people were just voting
oh,
on...
Oh, Jesus!
A lot of you people were just voting on who you thought was hottest. But it does appear more people think a vampire's hotter. What if I find neither hot? Something's wrong with you.
Vampires are hot.
What a solid argument.
Werewolves are big, fluffy babies.
I don't know, dude. Really, I just Google image search werewolf, and I think that's going to be, like... scary. We don't have to have a full debate about this, because I mean, this is just personal preference. You know what? I'll hit the hammer before any people change their mind. Vampires are hottest. Now that that's out of the way.
Vampires can be muscular.
Oh, do not get the werewolf fans started.
Yes.
The werewolf fans would beg to differ. You think a vampire is muscular? Wait till you see a werewolf.
Are bigger and muscular.
They've got muscles. They've got freaking muscles the size of goddamn football or something.
H-W-O-O.
Okay, no howling in my courtroom. I'm gonna say, getting to the bottom of which is more powerful, the vampire or the werewolf, I'm gonna say it's just a tie for now, guys. We can't come
they
to an honest conclusion.
Right places.
Stop! No writing fanfic in this courtroom. For now, the vampire-werewolf debate is put on hold.
Hiss.
Growl.
What are we doing, dude? I think about that sometimes.